Well, the first point I'd like to make is that for stained glass, all the shapes should be nice and simple. If you look at this drawing here, this is my pattern for cutting glass and every shape I have to cut. If you have really complicated shapes, firstly, they're very difficult to cut, but even if you manage to cut quite a difficult shape, what you'll find is it will want to crack afterwards. So you can have a very sparkly texture, like this one, or what we call a Flemish texture, like this one, or a seedy texture with lots of bubbles in it, like this one. But when you do have colour, it's not necessarily plain flat colour. Green can be plain flat green, or it can be streaky, and you can see that the colour varies very much. The pieces of glass are joined together with lead. If you mix the broad black lines with the narrow black lines, that can make your design look quite lively, but you must have the black lines. With the windows in Irvine, nobody can ever get very close to them. So if you do lovely, delicate drawings and subtle details, they'll be completely wasted. What you need to do is be bold, and that's really, really important. When you make a stained glass window, you have to draw it full size. And if you have a design that maybe is a bit fatter in proportion to the height, it will be very, very difficult to make it look the same as the design when it's bigger. It has to be the right proportion. First and foremost, your theme will be Irvine, the history, the position, the location, and the future. But also think about the natural world and how you might tie in your stained glass to the natural features that are already part of Trinity Church. I've got four circles based on wheels, not quite finished yet, but on the way. But you can see they're not like a drawing of a wheel, and that's what you can do too. You can choose to do a drawing, maybe of boats, maybe of birds, whatever you choose, but you don't have to end up with a drawing. You could end up with a symbol, just inspired by your subject.